Today, I'm in Wales because my best mate Chris is attempting to ride 7 Everests in 7 days. That's 8,849 vertical meters every day. The climb he's chosen to do it on is called
Stillamdam. No, that's not right. Stillamdam.
And so far, things haven't exactly gone to plan.
You can't do it!
I still can't do it.
Hey Jimmy.
Are you drinking beers, Leo?
Yeah, almost certainly.
Alright, I told Josh to bring beers.
What's been going down?
Chris has been riding his bike for 14 hours a day to raise as much money for charity and awareness for people about suicide prevention. I feel like I've been riding the bike for 14 hours a day.
Naturally, I turned up late. So we're 6 days into this challenge and a lot of things have happened.
A lot of things have happened. Day one, the weather was absolutely atrocious. I got here about 3 o'clock and Chris was in bits. He wasn't eating food, it wasn't getting in or wasn't absorbing it properly. Chucked him on the turbo and we just grinded out the day. It was miserable and horrible, but he hit the Everest elevation. Day two, we had him on the turbo for probably about half of the day on and off. It was all about recovering from day one. He wasn't happy. He went about 1,000 meters under elevation. That was the day that we also decided to not make it about doing an Everest every day and just make it about doing as much riding as he could possibly do between 6 a.m. and 10 p.m. every single day for the whole 7 days and just see where we get to. The challenge and the inspiration for people and the cause was way more important than actually just hitting a number every day. We leave his food and drink supplies up by a gate at the start of the climb, and there was a day where Chris got back to replenish his supplies and all of his stuff was gone. He phoned through, I ran up there and confirmed it was gone. I wasn't sure if he was just delirious or not, so we assumed everything was stolen. It was basically all of his food and 8 water bottles that we were using just to keep replenishing. Someone came over with some replacement, put out a post on the local Facebook group, and it turns out that someone saw the box, thought it was abandoned, took it to load the local food bank and donated it. The food bank saw the post and were like, oh, that's the guy doing the Everest, I should probably get in touch with them and give it back. So we got it all back. And we're gonna make a donation to the food bank because we felt really bad for taking food from them. Every day is different. Some days, I think 1 or 2 days, he's done more turbo than outside, but the others he's done more outside. So we're taking it day by day for definite. Yesterday was the first day that we introduced day time sleep into his day, and it's made, well, yesterday it made a huge difference. So he probably had 4 or 5 20 minute naps, always limited to 20 minutes, and then yesterday is the second day within the challenge that he's hit an Everest and he actually went over by 1,000 meters. So yesterday was absolutely massive. As with everything that seems to happen in this space, everything has a knock-on effect, and he is not very happy today. He is very miserable.
I'm just out of earshot of Chris, and this hill is savage. The only shallow gradient has a massive headwind on it. Apparently it's been a headwind for the whole last 6 days of riding. And then the other bits are like 11-12%. So there's no real break. Savage, savage hill choice.
I've had a really good idea.
Okay.
I think the residents of the hill, the sheep,
yeah,
I think they should tow Chris up. I think it's their duty.
So we've got some spare inner tubes. Who's got the best engineering brain here?
The farmer that owns the sheep on this hill, me and Jimmy were chatting to him and he was covered in blood and it was really weird and he was really nice in the end.
You're literally standing in shit.
Good morning and welcome to today's video. I'm Stillamdam and we're riding up Francis Cade 33 times today.
I think that was quite good.
Hi, I'm Francis Cade, welcome to today's video. No. Good morning, welcome to today's video.
Even in restaurants, me and French just go out to dinner, doesn't matter where it is, I always put a tea towel down.
Mr. Creosote.
What's Mr. Creosote?
I think many people know in 2020 I did a trenching challenge on Box Hill, which was descending and climbing the depth of the Mariana Trench to kind of highlight mental health awareness and the notion of spiraling downwards, and then being able to climb out of it again, and that there's always a way and a support network to help you climb out. This kind of followed on from that. The thing that's really important to talk about on the mental health side is people struggle 7 days a week. I wanted to try and attempt to see if I could potentially do 7 Everests in 7 days, which is always going to be a push, but at the end of the day it was about getting people's attention to then get people to talk, and I think that's happened. And ultimately trying to fundraise for Movember and the incredible work that they do in supporting mental health awareness and men's mental health, because us guys are shit at talking about how we're feeling and expressing it, and we're also, you know, the highest suicide rate in the UK is guys my age, and it's 91 men a week, which is quite scary. But ultimately I'm doing this to try and get people to reach out to someone they maybe haven't heard from for a while, send a text, drop them a phone call, because you could change someone's day and then you could change someone's life from something that's so simple and takes you 30 seconds. And I'm out of breath.
Oh, nice.
Go, Chris!
I heard about the challenge and I just thought I had to do something to impress him. So last week, still fresh, scabby.
He looks impressed.
That's ridiculous. Fucking hell.
He really loves music so much.
We got this. We got this. Just one more day.
I think we broke it.
Chris looks in better shape than you.
He does.
He actually does.
I think that's what's sending me down a hole.
On the whiteboard today, Francis, is each elevation for the day and then a running total of how far ahead he is. Day 1, 8851. Day 2, 7549. Day 3, 6403, I think. Day 4, 6501.
Do you want him to say this?
I mean, it's been around the entire time. I think he's gone blind after the nosebleed.
Nosebleed?
Yeah, the nosebleed earlier today. We were a little bit worried, but we told him, get back on the turbo.
Get on the bus.
That was yesterday.
That was yesterday.
Was that yesterday?
It was, wasn't it?
I don't know, all the days
were. Was that actually today?
I don't know, mate. No, all the days are blurring into one.
You were here today, weren't you?
When did you arrive?
Midday.
Did Chris's nose
Did you have a nosebleed?
No.
You didn't? Maybe it was yesterday.
Was it yesterday?
Listen, it was yesterday.
Chris! He's died. Three blind mice. Na 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 na. Three blind mice. Everested. On the turbo trainer.
Okay.
This is the worst idea ever.
Oh, wow.
Can you fart into one of them?
Yeah, great conditions for today.
Wow. It's like surfing, it's not skateboarding.
Day 7 and the final day of the challenge. It is now raining. A lot.
So this is the yellow bottle which holds the Sturka Mix 90. So we give him a few bottles of this, and every time he has a bottle of this, he also has a black bottle which is usually just water, or we add some of the Sturka salts in there as well. And then we just keep replacing these throughout the entire day.
How many do you think he's getting through?
Probably like several of each, like 4 or 5 of each.
Has what you've craved changed throughout the challenge?
Yes. I'm on the savoury train.
Yeah.
Now.
Sick of sweet stuff.
But it's changing. Like sometimes I just don't want anything, and then it'll be something like a piece of square of cheese. You know, like it's random, and it's just a case of trying to eat whatever I can. But to be honest, a lot of the time I'm just shoving shit down my mouth. But we're doing quite a lot in liquid, which is. So it is like easy calories, if that makes sense, easy carbs. Oh, Marshall, watch your foot.
Good, what was that?
I think we might have mentioned or not that we made it not about the elevation and just about getting through the day. So it was basically how much elevation could he do between 6 a.m. and 10 p.m. every day. We got to 10 p.m. and basically pulled him off. Day one we hit an Everest, but it was a really bad day. Day two and three got worse and worse and the elevation was going down. Day four he started to pull it back again and went up slightly, but still it wasn't an Everest. So two, three and four he did not Everest. Day five we were back in business. Yesterday focus was hit Everest, pull him straight off the bike. Today, get him through the day, hit an Everest. If we can get 4 out of 7, that's just like, can you imagine? I know, like, realistically, 7 in 7, I was kind of like, it's not gonna happen. 4 out of 7, like, that's still bonkers. Bearing in mind, that's also doing 3 days on top of that where he nearly Everest.
Have there been any days with no rain yet so far?
I don't think so. I genuinely don't think so.
So somehow we've made friends with the people from the power station who've given us the key with very little argument.
Very little argument. I think in the words of the guy, he was like, I don't really care, just give it back at the end of the day.
Usually this climb is completely closed to cars and it's just like a service road used to go up to the dam, I guess. So there's lots of people here on bikes and on longboards yesterday who are very disappointed to see that we've got a key and are ruining their lovely carless experience, but you know, charity, so it's allowed.
I'm the gatekeeper.
Are you friends with the power station man now?
Yeah, I can't tell you the horrible things I had to do to get that key. I'm scarred for life.
Military jet aircrafts can go past the stratosphere into the thermosphere. I don't know what any of those mean. It's pretty high.
How high is the shard?
I think he's ridden higher than the shard.
Yeah, but how many shards?
Oh, how many shards? Yeah.
The shard's 310 meters. So it's the shard stacked on top of each other 167 times.
So he's ridden up Box Hill 403 times.
Yeah, I thought we were on that.
Get him to surf a couple more, that's not that many.
Chris is not very well today, as you can see.
Probably got a little shot or something.